Hello students, today we are going to study about the spherical mirrors, in that concave mirror and convex mirror. Now in spherical mirror there are two types of mirrors, as you have studied, that is a concave mirror and convex mirror. Now first we will go with the concave mirror. In concave mirror, see reflections, you are going to study how the light rays falls on the concave mirror and how it reflects. This part you are going to study. Reflections at curved surface. As you know, this concave and convex mirrors are, it is a type of spherical mirror. Spherical means what? It is a sphere shape. And when you will cut the sphere, what happens? Two sections it produces. When one section of the spherical mirror, if the inner part of the surface reflects, then it is called as concave mirror. And if you will see the other part, if the outer part reflects, then it is called as convex mirrors. This you have studied. Now here you can see concave mirror, how this concave mirror reflects, that you are going to study. See, as I have told, this concave mirror means cave like structure which reflects the light. So in this type you can see one outer surface is coated and inner surface acts as a reflecting surface. Here you can see the light rays are falling on the concave mirror. Okay, as you have studied, if light falls on the mirror, it reflects back. Okay, plane mirror you have seen, it was very simple, it falls and it reflects back, obeying the law of reflection. Now here if you will see, the surface is not straight, it is curved. So you are going to study what happens if the surface will be curved. So light rays falls on the curved surface and it reflects back. How it reflects back? See, these are the parallel beam of light rays. It falls on the concave mirror. Here you can see this ray, it falls, it has strike back. Falls, it has reflect back. It has strike on the mirror, it reflects back. These rays, what happened? They reflect back. And what happens when they reflect back? They come and meet at one point, that is called as focus. Okay, so here I will explain you. See, as I have told you that this is a concave mirror, this is the reflecting part of the concave mirror. So what happens? Many light rays falls on the mirror. As it is curved surface, it falls and what happens? It reflects back. As it is a mirror, what happens? It reflects back. Sorry, I will draw here. As this is a straight line, what happens? It will, these are going towards the mirror and this will reflect back. This will also reflect back. This is reflecting back. If you will see, all the points which are reflect back, they meet at a point and this point is called as focus. Okay, this point is called as focus. And in last video you have studied, as you have studied that a point, okay, between which divides this, okay, or the middle of this concave mirror is called as pole P. This is the focus and here is the radius of curvature. Okay, and the focal length is always half to the radius of curvature. Okay, if you will see, this means these are equally placed. If you will see, this and these are equally placed, that is focal length equal to half the radius of curvature. That formula also, focal length f equal to half of radius of curvature divided by 2. This is a formula, it used for the problem solving, very important formula. Focal length equal to radius of curvature divided by 2. Okay, so this is how reflections takes place in the concave mirror. Just it is very simple. You can see here in concave mirror, this rays, when it reflects back, it focuses at one point, and where it is not behind the mirror, it is inside. Okay, here you can see in the inside only it focuses. So what happens? Because of this, focal length of concave mirror is always negative. Okay, because the focal length always lie inside. the place inside this mirror. That's why what happens, see, this focal length of convex mirror is always negative. If you will solve this, focal length equal to r divided by 2, you will always give a negative sign for concave mirrors. Focal length for concave mirror, the answer is always in negative. Okay, this you have to keep in mind. This sentence is very important for MCQs, and all these questions can come, that focal length of convex mirror is always dash, positive, negative, zero, none of these. Okay, so it is very important. Now here we will go for another part, convex mirror. It is opposite to it. You can see the outer surface is reflecting surface, inner surface is coated. Okay, so here same as that, light rays are falling on the surface. And what happened at this condition, it is reflecting back. You can see here, when it falls on the mirror, it reflects back. Here also it reflects back, here also and here also. Okay, light rays have fall on this surface and it has reflect back. I will draw here separately and I will show you so that you can clearly understand it. Okay, first I will draw this convex lens. Here you can see the inner part is coated of the convex mirror. Sorry, not, it is not lens. These are the light rays. This I am drawing a principal axis, as we have studied. The line which passes through the center of the convex mirror or any spherical lens, it is called as principal axis. It's principal axis I have drawn. I am drawing the rays which are falling on the convex mirror. See, this light rays are falling on the convex mirror and it is reflecting back. Okay, how it is reflecting? Now see, as the surface is like this, okay, outcome is there. So what happens, it falls and it reflects outward. Now as here it was focusing towards, because it the surface was like this curve, so what happens, it was focusing at one point, but it is how, it is opposite to that, so it is reflecting the light rays outward. Okay, here you can see it is reflecting the light rays outward. Now how you will find the focus over here? Now you have to extend this reflected light rays, you have to extend back. Okay, and when you will extend back, at one point they all meet and this is your focus. And as you know, here this is a convex mirror, so the radius of curvature will be here. Okay, so this is how you will find a focus in the convex mirror. Okay, so this is the focus, this is the center of curvature. Understood? So in this, now what will be the focal length here, as it is beyond, means here light rays are reflecting in the same surface, you can see here. Okay, light rays are reflecting here outside and you are focusing here. Okay, the focus point you are getting here behind that. So here what happens, see, this focal length of convex mirror is always positive. Okay, this is very important. Convex, now focal length for convex mirror will be what, r divided by 2, that is radius of curvature divided by 2, it is always positive. If you will solve this, the answer you are getting should be always positive, because focal length of convex mirror is always positive. Okay, understood? So this was the topic. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. And this part is very important, so listen carefully to this video. This will be very helpful for your next classes. When you will go for further classes, it will help you. So please try to understand this concept, and if you have any doubt, feel free to ask me. Thank you.